Hi guys, welcome to Test Automation Design from Scratch. In the previous session of videos, we have covered the agenda of the distributed version control system and the topics that have been covered up, and we have seen some introductory concepts in the Git and GitHub. So let's have a quick recap of whatever we have covered. So let's get into details. So basically, what we have covered is a brief introduction, brief history of version control systems, the different types of version control systems, local models, centralized version control system, what is the drawback of it, and the distributed version control system, and then how the users are classified, that is the Git user classification, and then the Git workflow, Git everyday users, Git installation, installing local Git repository, overview of label decorations, and Git perspective repository view, Git everyday commands, and followed by adding a project to the version control system and understanding what is GitHub and configuring account creation for the GitHub and configuring creating a remote repository and uploading or pushing the changes to the central repository GitHub. So this is the agenda that we have been trying to cover, and let's have a quick recap of what we have covered earlier in the previous session of video. So local data models, it is the earliest version of the model that have been implemented. So there are, due to some drawbacks that they are not able to collaborate over across the regions, they had to work only in the local system. That is the drawback of the local data models, and it is not useful when teams are collaborated across regions, so it is not possible. So then the next concept has come into play is a centralized version control system. We have a central server that had to be every time up and running. Only then we will be able to make changes, commit changes or push changes, or we will be able to work on any code changes. So that is the drawback of the centralized version control system. That is, if the centralized version control system is down for half an hour, no one will be able to make any changes, no one will be able to commit changes, no one will be able to do any work. So it is almost an half an hour, 1 hour downtime will give rise to a development team sitting idly for 1 hour or half an hour. So this is the main drawback of centralized version control system. And next is the distributed version control system, which I have been dealing with. As an example of distributed version control system is Git. And for an example, the centralized version control system, we can take purpose. And for distributed version control system, we can take an example of Git. So as we already discussed, Git is like a client server model, where Git is a client and which lies in our local repository, which acts as a local repository in our system, residing in our system, in every PC, every developer's PC. And the GitHub acts as a central repository in the central server. Maybe it is located on the cloud, or it is located somewhere else centrally. And we will be having the local copy or the local version of the same, or the replica of the repository residing in the central GitHub. The same replica is copied and it is maintained in our local systems. That is, every developer will be having a replica of the copy on the local server. So even the central server goes down, that is GitHub comes down, there is no problem absolutely, since the developer will be able to make changes in his own local system. And then when he will be able to connect back to the central repository, he will be able to push the changes to the central repository. So this is the advantage of distributed version control system. And we have covered the user classification. The Git users are classified into that. They are the individual developers, that is the standalone developers will be using the standalone commands, which is used for everyday users. And the next is the individual developer participant. He'll be able to do some basic commands which he'll be able to perform on a system. And then the integrator will be able to push the changes and review the codes. So the integrator role is just to integrate or push the changes, or he will be able to review the things, and then he'll be able to merge the code to the central repository. So this is the role of the integrator and the repository administrator. Repository administrator is the one who deals with the creation of providing permissions or giving access rights to all the users, and also merging, and also, he will be the guy who will be taking care of and maintaining the repositories. So the user classification is basically done to ensure that everybody is seen to have a different rights. So every user, every developer is restricted to perform different tasks. So basically, they do not want all the developers to have all the rights, all the people in the organization to have all the rights. So that's the reason they maintain repository administrator and repository integrator and individual developers and individual developer participants. So this is how the user classification has been evolved. And the Git workflow, as we already seen, we'll be having the three layers in our local system. That is working directory, the present working directory which we'll be using up in the Eclipse. That is the workspace where we will be working on the changes. And then we'll be once the modification have been done, we'll be adding those changes to the staging area. And then someone will be able to review the changes over there. That is the staged area. On the staging area, someone will be able to review the changes, and if everything is fine, and then they will be able to commit the changes to the local repository. Once it has been committed to the local repository, those changes will be pushed up to the central repository. So Git everyday commands. So Git everyday uses commands. So let's see how to get the Git everyday uses commands. So Git everyday commands. So let's see how to get the Git everyday commands from the Git installation itself. So launch the Git bash. Once we launch the Git bash, add the command git help hyphen g. So it lists how the Git user guide is segregated into. Git user guide is segregated into attributes, everyday, glossary, ignore, modules, revisions, tutorials, workflows. So basically we wanted to see Git everyday commands. So we need to type git help in quotations everyday, quotations close. So you can see the git everyday manual page is opened over here. So these are the list of commands. So as I told, how the grouping has been done, user grouping has been done. So this is how it has been done. And then, so these are the everyday commands that a standalone developer will be using. So what the developer will be using in day-to-day life, day-to-day activities. Git init to initiate, to create a new repository. Git log to see what happened over the history. That is, the history of the commits can be verified using Git log. Git checkout and Git branch. Git checkout is used for checking out the branch that is specified. And Git branch is used for creating a new branch or switching to the branch specified. Git add is used to manage the index file. That is, a new change is made, and then that new changes in the file, that change files need to be pushed into the staging area. So that is accomplished using git add. Git diff is used for verifying the difference from the present commit to the previous commit. And status. Git status is used to identify what are the changes that have been made, what is the difference that has been there, what is unstaged, if there are any unstaged changes, if there are any staged changes. To verify all these things, git status is used. And git commit. Git commit is used to advance to the current branch. That is, any changes have been made and that have been moved to the staging area, and then we wanted to move it to the local repository, merge to the local repository, we'll be using the git commit command. And git reset, git checkout. Git checkout, as we have already seen, it is used to move to the current branch. Whatever the branch we specify, git checkout branch name, it will be checking out, it will be opening out to that particular branch. Git merge is used to merge two local branches. Assume we have been in the main branch, and then we created we have got a new user story, and then we created a new branch to work on the changes over there instead of directly working on the main branch. So now, once the changes have been verified and tested on the secondary branch, and then we wanted to merge it to the primary branch. So at that point of time, we'll be using git merge. Git tag is used to identify some point in time using a specified version identifier, etc. And then we wanted to move to that particular version and see what are the changes were there as a part of that version. So for that identification, we want to tag up something like the version number or something. We use git tag. So as we have seen, these are the day-to-day activities that will be performed. You can see clearly in this pictorial representation itself. So what are the various activities that will be performed in a day-to-day life of the developers or the testers? So creating repositories, synchronizing repositories using push-pull and then add origin, and then making changes using status, add, and then commit, and parallel deployment using transform, merge, and replace. Next, Git installation. So basically,